Americans working for China's semiconductor sector are facing a potential dilemma. A U.S. ban on semiconductors could force them to make a choice: stick to the jobs that help China advance its microchip technology, or keep their citizenship. We look into why.
The U.S. is tightening its stranglehold on China's microchip development. The Commerce Department is coming out with a new restriction, barring U.S. persons from helping China's microchip development without a license. Here's the group that falls under the U.S. persons category: U.S. citizens, permanent residents, people that live in the U.S., and American companies. The new measure is a blow for China, as many key persons helping the regime's development in the semiconductor sector have U.S. residency. Among them, at least 43 senior executives at Chinese semiconductor companies are American citizens. That's according to a report from the Wall Street Journal. One example is Gerald Ng. He's the founder of AMEC, China's top semiconductor equipment maker. Ng spent almost two decades working for the U.S. microchip giants, like Intel and Applied Materials. After stints in Silicon Valley, Ng went back to China and founded AMEC. Semiconductors are key to U.S.-China competition. These tiny chips are the hearts and brains of modern electronics, and make everything from iPhones to cars to fighter jets possible. Advanced chips are also critical for military technology. The U.S. ban drew immediate reaction. Several big names in the industry have put holds on their American employees' work in China while waiting for officials to clarify the rules. Examples include Dutch equipment maker ASML and U.S. chipmakers KLA and Lam Research.